Greetings, everyone.
大家好。
It's such a joy to be with you.
我今天很开心跟大家一起在一起。
We are in for a wonderful time together.
我今天我相信我会有一段美好的经历。
Before I start,
我在开始之前
I want to express gratitude from our church in Hastings.
我要代表我的教会向大家表示我的深深的感谢。
I want to say thank you from the people in Hawke's Bay.
我要从我 Hawke's Bay 的弟兄姐妹来向他们感谢。
When Pastor Lee heard about the problem we had gone through,
当李牧师听到我们教会所经历的困难的时候
，Word went out among Chinese people.
我们这些事情就在许多中华人教会里面传开。
And thousands of dollars were gifted.
有数以千计的这些金元来到我们的当中。
And we were able to use that finance.
我们就可以用这样子的一个资助
，along with the resources of our own church.
还有我们教会这边的资源。
We housed over 160 people in the church.
我们让160个当时没有办法居住的人来到有地方住。
We fed them for 3 meals a day.
我们只供应他们一天三餐。
We sent equipment out into the community to help with the excavations.
我们将许多的器具带到社区中，使他们可以得困。
We obtained generators so that people could have power.
我们这样子，所以使许多人可以有资源，可以有供电。
We filled gas bottles so people could have gas to cook.
我们可以给他们瓦斯，所以他们可以去煮饭。
And our church reached out into the community.
然后我们的教会能够进入到社区里面。
Providing food and meals.
来去供应他们食物。
And I want to say thank you.
我要谢谢你们。
Thank you for your heart to help.
谢谢你们那热心帮助。
Thank you for your generosity.
谢谢你们的慷慨。
We are blessed that you are part of our nation.
我们很感恩，我们是因你们而蒙福。
And that you are praying for revival.
因为我们今天你们也为了我们教我家的复兴。
And are practically involved.
来祷告，也实际的参与其中。
So from the bottom of my heart.
所以从我的内心深处。
From our church.
从我的教会。
Thank you.
谢谢你。
We appreciate you.
谢谢你们，我非常的感谢。
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, well, I want to speak a session on empowered by the Holy Spirit.
所以今天我要跟大家分享如何被圣灵来去
自行能力。We need the Holy Spirit.
我需要圣灵。
Every one of us needs the Holy Spirit.
我每一个人都需要圣灵的能力。
I can remember many years ago.
我可以记得许多年前。
I was in a meeting.
我在一个聚会当中。
It wasn't even a Pentecostal or charismatic meeting.
哦，并不是一个圣灵充满的一个聚会。
And there was an emptiness.
但是这我就感到许许多空虚。
There was a loneliness in my heart.
在我的心中，我就感到空虚寂寞。
And I remember just reaching out.
我就记得当我往前走。
And I said, Lord.
我说主啊。
I don't know what this Holy Spirit is.
我并不知道这个圣灵到底是什么。
I don't know what speaking in tongues is.
我不知道说方言是什么意思。
But I know I need this.
但是我知道我需要这个。
And immediately the Holy Spirit fell on me.
就立刻那圣灵就临到我的当中。
I didn't even know what had happened to me.
我不知道发生了什么。
I just...was speaking in a new language.
但是我就开始说一个新的语言。
And day after day, I would go for a walk.
然后每一天我去散步的时候。
And as I prayed in the spirit,
让我就在灵里祷告。
I could feel this joy filling my life.
我就感受到从我里面那深深的那个喜悦。
And our lives took a change in direction from that point.
我们的生命不再一样，完全改了方向。
When we became filled with the spirit,
当我们被圣灵充满的时候。
God began to direct our lives.
圣灵开始来去指引我们的生命。
And within about 3 years,
在三年之后
we were fully involved in ministry.
我们就完全的在事工当中。
I want to read from you a promise that Jesus made.
我想给你们读一个耶稣给我们的应许。
In John chapter 14, verse 16 through to 18.
约翰福音十四章十六到十七节。
Jesus is about to complete his ministry on the earth.
耶稣马上就要完成他在地上的事工。
He's about to die and be raised from the dead and leave his disciples.
他马上就要为我们受死，并且要复活。也要离开他的门徒。
And they are very concerned about this.
所以他们的门徒就非常的担忧。
And he says, I will pray to the Father, and he will give you another help that he may abide with you forever.
耶稣就说，我要求父，父就另外赐你一位保惠师，叫他永远与你们同在。
It is the Spirit of truth whom the world cannot receive, because it doesn't see him or know him, but you know him, he dwells with you and will be in you.
那就是真理的灵，乃世人所不能接受的，因为不见他，也不认识他，你们却认识他，因他常与你们同在，也要在你们里面。
I will not leave you orphans.
我不会让你们好像孤儿一样。
But I will come to you.
但是我会来到你的面前。
So you notice there an important thing that Jesus said.
你可以看到这里面耶稣说一件很重要的事情。
I will not leave you orphaned.
我不会让你好像孤儿一样的。
In the Bible, an orphan is someone without a father.
在圣经里面，孤儿就是没有父亲的人。
They may have a mother.
也许他有母亲。
But without a father,
但是没有父亲，
they're considered to be an orphan.
他们就被称为孤儿。
Why is that?
为什么呢？
The word father means a source.
因为这个词父亲就像是一个根源。
In the Bible, a father is a source of provision.
在圣经里面，父亲就是
He's a source of protection.
是保护的根源，是供应的根源。
A source of identity.
是我们能够去证明认真我生命的本源的。
A source of guidance.
是他能够来去引导我们的根源。
A source of direction.
是来让我们知道我们要往哪个方向去。
This is what a father does.
这就是一个父亲的角色。
And God desires us to be children.
那神希望我们成为他的孩子。
Who are not orphans.
并不是孤儿。
In the Bible, the word son,
在圣经里面，儿子，
it means one who builds the father's house.
就是那个去建立他父亲的家的人。
So Jesus says this.
所以当耶稣这样说，
I will not leave you orphaned.
当我不会让你变成孤儿。
Alone.
独自在这世上
without a source of protection,
没有任何人来保护你
without a source of provision,
没有任何来供应你
without a source of guidance,
没有任何来指引你
but I will make a provision for you,
但是我一定会供应你
I will pray to the Father,
我会向那天父来祷告
and he will send you another helper,
他会差遣你一个帮助你的人
So Jesus said the answer to being an orphan,
耶稣对于成为孤儿的一个答案就是
being alone and struggling on your own
就是那些你如果是独立自己还很孤单的人
the answer to being an orphan
这有一个解答
struggling to promote yourself protect yourself provide for yourself
也许你很一直在很困难的觉得说我一定要为自己来供应什么
is we receive from the Father his supply
那解答就是我们向供应我的天父来寻求
I will send you another helper
我会差遣另外一个帮助者
the word another means exactly the same as the one you've had.
这个是另一个，就是说跟你现在有的是一模一样的。
So he's saying, I'm leaving you physically.
虽然他说我现在身体上我要离开你们了。
But you'll never be alone.
但是你从来再也不会是孤
独的。For I will send someone to you.
因为我要差遣另外一位。
He will be a helper.
他是一个要帮助你的。
What does that mean?
这什么意思呢？
The word helper means one who is called near to you.
这一个字帮助者就是说那个差遣来到你身边的人
The Holy Spirit is sent to be near to us
圣灵是被差遣要来到我们的身旁
How near can he get?
他能够与我们有多那么靠近呢
Jesus said you've seen him with you
耶稣说你曾经看见他与你们同在
Soon he will come to be within you
他也要到你们在你们里面
I will send you a helper
我会差遣你一个帮助者
Someone who will be with you
他会与你同在
Whatever situation you face,
不管你所经历的是什么
you will never be alone.
你再也不孤单
You will have someone with you,
你一定会有人与你同在
whose assignment is to help you.
他的工作就是要去帮助你
Why does God send someone to help us?
为什么神要差遣一个人来帮助我们
Because he knows we need help.
因为他知道我们需要帮助
He wants us to be like children.
他希望我们就像孩子一样
talk with him,
来向父亲来说话
and receive his help.
并且从他那领受帮助
If you're a parent, you need help.
如果你是一个为人父母的人，你需要帮助。
If you run a business, you need help.
如果你是企业主，你也需要帮助。
If you have struggles, you need help.
如果你经历困难，你需要帮助。
Only proud people don't need help.
只有那些骄傲的人认为他不需要帮助。
But the rest of us need all the help we can get.
但是我们其他人，我们需要我们所能得到一切的帮助。
I will send a helper.
我会差遣一个帮助者。
And he won't be outside you.
他不会在你的外面。
He will be within you.
他会在你的里面。
You can't get close.Than that.
你并不能比这个还要靠近了。
So Jesus promised.
是耶稣来应许我们。
He promised us the Holy Spirit.
他应许我们要差给我们圣灵。
He said, "I won't leave you orphans."
他说我不会使你们成为孤儿。
I won't leave you without someone to help.
我不会让你们孤单无助。
I will send you the Holy Spirit.
我会差遣圣灵来帮助你。
So the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of God.
所以那圣灵就是神的灵。
And He is unlimited.
他是无穷无尽的。
So if we want His help,
如果我们需要他的帮助
we must build relationship with Him.
我们必须要与他建立关系。
We must learn to recognize His voice.
我们必须要去学会聆听 认知他的声音
and share our life with him.
然后跟他来去分享我的生命
When people come to the Lord,
当人们来到耶稣面前的时候
they often just come with a prayer list.
他们常常就只是带了一个代祷清单
But the Holy Spirit is more than someone who solves your prayers.
但是圣灵是远远超过他只能够为你来解决你祷告的事项的
He is your friend.
他是你的朋友
He is your counselor.
他是与你能够分享的人
He gives you help.
他给你帮助
He shows you what to do.
他告诉你应当做什么
God's desire is we develop an intimate connection with the Holy Spirit.
神的心意是让我们能够跟圣灵建立那个亲密的关系。
So when Jesus said, "I'm about to leave,"
所以当耶稣说我马上要离开你们了
He didn't leave us a book; he left us a person.
他并没有只是给我一个指南，他给我们一个人。
We have the Bible.
所以我们有圣经。
And the Bible is important.
圣经非常的重要。
Because it was inspired by the Holy Spirit.
因为那是圣灵所默示的。
But you don't just need the book.
但是你不是只是需要
圣经。You need the one who inspired the book.
你更需要那个去默示的那个人。
Otherwise, you can't understand what it means.
不然你很多时候你看不懂。
Or how it applies to your life.
或者要怎么样将它实际放在你的生命当中。
So Jesus made a promise.
所以耶稣做了个应许。
The promise of the Holy Spirit.
应许那圣灵要来到。
Notice this, he said he will never leave you.
也就是说他再也不要离开你。
What if I have a bad day?
哇，如果我经历一个很糟糕的一
天 He'll never leave you.
他也不会离开你。
What if I argue with my spouse?
Oh, 如果跟我太太或先生吵架怎么办
He never leave you.
他也跟你在一起
What if I had a row with my children?
如果我跟我孩子起争执呢
He never leave you.
他也不会离开你
The promise is true.
那个应许是真实的
He won't leave us.
他永远不离开我们
Our responsibility
我们的要做的是什么
is to build a relationship with the Holy Spirit.
那就是要跟圣灵去建立一个很好的关系
Understand his work.
我来去清楚他的工作是什么
When God gives you a gift,
当神给你一个礼物
receive the gift gladly.
就非常欢欢喜喜的领受吧
Welcome the gift.
我们就很欢迎这样的礼物
When you welcome the giver,
当你去欢迎那赐予的人的时候
You receive what he has to give you.
那你就领受他所给你的
You don't look at the gift.
你不是看着那个礼物
Oh, I don't like that too much.
我不喜欢这个东西
I'll only have a little bit.
我只要一点点就好
Receive the Holy Spirit.
你就领受那圣灵吧
Everything he has for you.
所有他所要赐给你的
The Bible tells us.
那圣经告诉我们
The Holy Spirit helps us.
圣灵来帮助我们
We need help.
我们需要帮助
We don't know what to do.
我们不知道应该做什么
The Holy Spirit teaches us.
那圣灵就来教导我们
So when you read the Bible.
所以当我们读圣经的时候
You need the Holy Spirit to teach you.
你需要圣灵来教导我们
How to apply it to life.
要怎么样的应用在我的生命当中呢
The Holy Spirit.
那圣灵
Gives revelation to us.
是启示的灵
That means he tells you things you don't know.
他告诉你你所不知道的。
He reveals things to you.
他慢慢将它显现给你看到。
Let me tell you something.
让我来告诉你吧。
I remember when I was a very young Christian.
但我还记得我还是很年轻的基督徒的时候。
And my grandmother was very annoyed that I was no longer following traditional church.
我的祖母非常的讨厌，就不是很舒服。我好像不是根据传统教会的这个信仰来走。
She was very upset with me.
她实在是不是很开心。
And I'm thinking, oh, I need to buy her a very nice birthday present.
我就想说我应该要给她买一个很好的生日礼物。
But I got busy.
但是我好忙啊，哎呀。
I forgot the birthday.
我忘记了今天是她生日。
And I remember saying.Holy Spirit,
我说圣灵啊
help me,
帮助我
I don't know what to do,
我不知道怎么办
And I'm walking down the street thinking, well, I better buy a good big present.
哎呀，我走在路上，我想说，我一定要买一个最大的礼物
Natural thinking,
嗯，人的想象
And as I walk past this Christian shop,
哎，当我走过一个基督教的一个
the Holy Spirit
那个商店的时候
go inside,
哎，圣灵就跟我讲进去
I went inside and had a look,
我进去要看一看
And there was a picture there,
那边就一个
of the good shepherd with the sheep,
啊，就是那个好牧人跟他的羊。
And the Lord said, buy that.
那神就说买那个。
I thought, oh, I don't even like that picture, man.
我自己都不喜欢这个照片耶。
And I went out to the shop and down the road.
然后我就再去另外一家店。
Then I came back again. Okay, I'll buy this one.
然后回来我就说好吧好吧我买这个吧。
I bought it.
然后我买它了。
And I bought some flower arrangement.
我还买一些花。
I sent to my grandmother.
然后我就送给我的祖母。
A little while later, I asked her, oh, you get my gift?
之后我说，哎，你有拿到收到我的礼物吗？
Very beautiful dried flowers.
她说，那个花，干花很漂亮。
I said, what about the picture?
那幅画呢？
Did you get the picture?
你有拿到那幅画吗？
Of course she got it. It was in the same pack.
那当然了，这是在同一个包裹里面，她一定收到了嘛。
But I was curious.
但我很好奇，
Why the Holy Spirit tell me buy that picture?
为什么圣灵叫我要买那幅画？
And she said to me,
她就对我说
Oh, when I saw that picture,
当我看到那幅画的时候
I remember something from many years ago.
我就想起那许久之前的一件事情
She was 74,
她74岁
When I was 12,
我是12岁的时候
We had caused trouble with our teacher.
哦、我们好像造成了文老师的一些、麻烦。
And we wanted to say sorry.
我们要对老师说不好意思 ，sorry.
We bought her a picture.
我们就买了衣服换给她。
We bought her that picture.
我们就买了那一幅画，同样的一幅画。
When I saw that picture,
当我看到那一幅画
，I always attach it with someone saying sorry.
我马上就想到有人对我说 sorry.
See, only the Holy Spirit could know.
所以只有圣灵能够知道
all the details of her life.
那些在她十二岁里面生活的
And what I could do that would make an impact.
那我能够做什么能够对她生命有影响呢
？So many stories like that. God is interested in us.
我有许许多多这样的故事。上帝很在意我生命中的每件事。
Now I want to speak about.Two different activities of the Holy Spirit.
所以我想跟你们分享，圣灵有两个很不一样的一个工作。
We could call them two different anointings.
我们也可以说他们是两种不同的恩膏。
When we use the word anointing,
当我们用这个词恩膏或膏抹
it just means the empowerment of the Holy Spirit.
就是说那是圣灵大能。
It's an empowerment, helps us get something done.
来去赐予我们，让我能够完成一些事情。
So let me help you understand two different anointings.
那我就让来帮助你们了解两种不同的恩膏。
The first one is the anointing within, which Jesus just promised.
第一种是那种内在的恩膏，也就是耶稣所应许的。
The second one is the anointing that comes upon us.
另外一种是那是外在的恩膏。
They are different.
那有点不太一样。
If I give you water to drink, it's in you.
如果我给你水来喝，那就在你里面。
If I get the water and pour it on you, it's on you.
如果我把水倒在你头上，那就是淋到你了。
Very, very different.
非常的不一样。
Water on you,
淋到你
you get wet.
你就变成淋湿了。
Water in you,
你喝在水里
your thirst is quenched.
那你的渴就得到解除了。
For different reasons.
是不一样，有不一样的理由。
Let's talk first about the anointing within.
那第一个我来说内在的恩膏。
In Romans 8 verse 15,
罗马书八章十五节
you did not receive the spirit of bondage again to fear, you received the spirit of adoption by whom we cry out, Abba, Father.
你们所受的不是奴仆的心，仍旧害怕，所受的乃是儿子的心，因此我们呼叫
And the Spirit bears witness with our spirit, we are the children of God.
圣灵与我们的心同证，我们是神的儿女。
So notice now, it's talking aboutReceiving the Spirit of God.
所以你看到吗？他们讲说是领受圣灵的灵。
He is the Spirit that places us into sonship.
是让这个圣灵使我们能够成为神的儿女。
So the first activity of the Holy Spirit.
所以这神的灵的第一件事情工作。
When He enters our life.
当他进入到我们的生命里。
When we receive Christ as our Savior.
那就是在我们领受耶稣成为救主的时候。
He wants you to know deep within your heart.
他要让你知道，在你内心的深处知道。
You are a child of God.
你就是属神的孩子。
You're no longer what you used to be.
你不再是你曾经的身份。
You are now different.
你现在完全不一样。
Before, without the Spirit of God,
之前没有圣灵
now with the Spirit of God,
现在是有圣灵
you are a child of God.
有圣灵你就是神的儿女
you can call God your father,
你可以呼叫神说阿爸父
you are carrying the life of God,
你是来去承接他的生命
within your spirit,
在你的灵里面
so when the Spirit of God comes to live within us,
所以当神的灵来住在我们心里的时候
his first function is to establish who we are.
他第一个工作就是来建立我们身份的认同 你是神的儿女
you have a bad day,
也许你经历一个不好的日子
you're still a child of God.
你还是神的儿女
you argue with your wife,
你跟你的太太吵架
you're still a child of God.
你还是神的孩子
but behaving not so good.
但是你可能不是做得很好
but it doesn't change who you are.
但是并不能改变你的身份
so the Spirit of God is given to us,
所以那圣灵是来赐予我们
to establish our identity,
来去建立我们的身份
to work and bring about transformation inside us,
是要带来我们内在生命的改变和更新
so a baby is not a full mature person,
所以我们看到一个小孩子他并不是一个成熟的大人
he has to grow up,
他需要去成长
so when God puts his Spirit inside you,
所以当神将他的灵放在你的心中的时候
one of the major roles of the Spirit,
这个圣灵他的最大的工作之一
is to grow you up,
是要来去使你成长
to grow you and transform you,
是来去使你成长并且使你来改变
so in your heart and your character,
所以你的心和你的这个
you become more like Jesus Christ,
所以你的个性越来越像耶稣一样
more loving,
更爱人
more courageous,
更有勇气
the work of the Spirit within you,
那圣灵那个在你心中的工作
is to change you,
是要去改变你
It's his responsibility to change you.
是他的责任来去改变你。
You don't have to try hard to change yourself.
你并不需要非常的努力的想要去改变你自己。
It's his job to change.
因为那是神的工作。
That's why he's given to you.
这是为什么圣灵要来。
To bring about change.
是要来去改变。
Bring about transformation.
是来带来更新。
All your responsibility
所以你要做什么呢
is to listen to him
是要去聆听他的话
and respond to him
并且对他做出正确的反应
If you're holding unforgiveness
如果你是不饶恕什么人
he will make you aware of it
他会来告诉你知道
respond to him and forgive
你要去回应他然后去饶恕人
If you are acting dishonestly
如果你是一个不诚实的人
and he makes you aware of it
然后圣灵告诉你有不诚实的事
respond to him and repent
你要回应并且悔改
If you are lacking love
如果你没有爱
Then respond to him.
那你就要去回应他
Receive his love.
从他领受大爱
And show more love to people.
然后去相的爱展现
His responsibility.
所以他的责任
Is to transform you.
是来去更新变化你
Your responsibility.
你的责任
Is to listen to him.
是来去聆听
And surrender to what he's showing you.
并且来去降服在他所显示给你的事上
And depending on him to help you.
来去依靠他的能力来帮助你
it makes it a lot easier
这不就很简单了吗
than trying to look at everything that's wrong and fix it
不然的话我看见我生命中的破洞要去努力的修改
The Holy Spirit plans your journey of transformation
那圣灵为我们这个更新改变做出了极大的计划
So every situation that happens in life
所以不管我们生命中经历了什么
is an opportunity to change and grow
都是一个可以去改变和成长的契机
One of the big problems
有一个很大的问题
Christians that don't want to grow
那就是基督徒实在不想要成长
They want to remain babies
他们就好想要当属灵的婴儿
They want someone to pamper them
啊，希望有人来拍拍我们
They want to just do what they want
我只是想随心所欲我想怎么就做什么呀
Holy Spirit
但是那圣灵啊
is wanting to raise you up
是希望你能够成长啊
to become mature sons
能够成为一个成熟的孩子
to represent your father
能够去代表你的父亲
and who work with him
与他一起动工同工
to build his house
来去建造他的房屋
that's what sons do
那就是儿子的职分
they are builders
他们是要去建造的人
babies just eat a lot
那小 baby 只是吃
and they cry a lot
就哭
And they mess up a lot.
然后他们就捣乱。
Don't stay a baby.
哎呀，不要再做一个婴孩
了。Grow up.
长大吧。
And become a builder.
成为一个建筑建造的人。
Someone who does something with the gifts God has given them.
那一个是能够使用圣灵给你恩赐来建造的人吧。
Everyone is a child of God.
每一个人都是属神的儿女。
God wants you to grow up.
神要你来成长。
To mature in love.
来去成熟。
To mature in wisdom.
在智慧上成熟。
And to be a builder.
来建造。
To build people,
来去建造别人。
You can't build people if you won't relate to them properly.
如果你要建造别人，你如果没有跟他建立关系，是做不到的。
If you're an angry person,
如果你是一个很容易生气的人
，you're not going to build people. You'll tear them down.
你没有办法建造，你只能拆毁。
If you're a bitter person,
如果是一个苦毒的人
，you won't build people.
你没有办法建造人的。
You'll hurt them with your bitterness.
只有会因为你的苦毒去伤害别人的。
God wants you to grow up.
所以神要你来成长。
God wants you to grow up,
神要你成长
so you can represent what he's like,
所以你能够去代表他是一个怎么样
的人 and build people,
来去建造别人
expand his kingdom,
来去扩张他的神的
国度 so one of the key roles of the Holy Spirit within us,
所以圣灵在我们内在里面一个重要的工作是
is to establish our identity,
去来使我们建造我们的
身份 and grow us up and mature us,
并且使他能够成长使我们能够建造
so don't stay a baby Christian,
不要再作为一个属灵的婴孩了
Study the word of God
去读神的话语
Begin to listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit
去聆听圣灵的话
Build a life of prayer
能够去有一个祷告的生命
Grow up
长大
And when you come to a meeting or a gathering
当你来到一个聚会的时候
Have something to contribute
你能够做些什么呢
Instead of always want someone meet my need
不是总是希望有人能够来帮我就好了
We've got a baby in our house at the moment
我们家里现在有个小 baby
You can always tell when it wants something
他一定可以告诉我他要东西的时候
Crying
就是哭嘛
He said well we don't want that in the church
但是我们不要这样的事情在教会里面
You want people to grow up
你要让我们教会的弟兄姐妹来成长
Take responsibility
来去承担责任
Start to serve
来去服事
Start to build others
来去建造别人
Now a second work of the Holy Spirit within us
那圣灵第二个工作是什么呢
Is to lead us
是来去引导我们
Let's see what it says
我来看他就说什么
In Romans 8 verse 14
来罗马书八章十四节
As many as are led by the Spirit of God These are the mature sons of God.
因为凡被神的灵引导的都是神的儿子。
Jesus was led or guided by the Holy Spirit.
所以耶稣也是被圣灵来引导的。
The Holy Spirit wants to lead you.
那圣灵想要来引导你。
In other words, give you guidance and direction.
也就是说他要来去指导你的未来的方向。
There are many, many things we have to make decisions about.
在我的生命中我也要做出许多的决定。
And it's not easy to know what to do.
我实在不是很容易知道我每件事要做什么。
Where should I live?
我要住哪里。
What house should I buy?
我要买什么房子。
What job should I do?
我要做什么工作。
Who will I marry?
我要跟谁结婚。
The list goes on.
许多的事情。So
many questions.
还有好多好多的问题。
But the Bible promises us.
但是这圣灵告诉我们。
The Holy Spirit will lead us.
那圣灵来引导我们。
He will give you guidance.
他会来指引我们前方的道路。
He will give you direction.
他会给你方向。
I remember when we bought the house we live in.
我记得当我买我现在住的房子的时候。
I didn't want to buy another house. I was very happy with the one I had.
我不想要买那个房子，因为我很喜欢我住刚刚住的，我现在住的房子。
We had two prophetic messages.
但是我有两个这先知性的话语领导我。
That God was going to enlarge our house.
那神要来去扩展我们的家。
And I thought, okay.
Okay.
So we'll go have a look.
那我们就去看一看吧。
So we looked at about three or four houses.
我们看了大概两三间吧。
I said that's enough.
我说这够了够了。
Lord, if you want us to have a bigger house,
我说主啊，如果你要我一个大的房子
，bring the house to me. I'm going to be busy doing your work.
你把房子带到我面前吧，我实在太忙了，要做你的工了。
So one day,
所以有一天
，one of the staff members,
有一个工作人员
said, "Oh, Pastor, we were looking at houses and we saw one, and when we saw the house, we thought of you."
哦，他说，哎，牧师长，我们在看房子的时候，我看到这间，我就想到，哎呀，我想到康牧师了。
So I went and looked at the house.
所以我就去看那个房子。
We quite liked it.
哎，我还蛮喜欢。
And I went home and prayed.
所以我回家我就祷告。
And the Lord spoke very clearly from Scripture.
哎，所以神在那圣经里面写得很清楚。
This is the house I've got for you.
这就是我所为你预备的房子。
It was so clear.
这么的清楚明白啊。
Okay.
Okay.
So I went to the man.
所以我就去找那个中介。
Okay, I buy the house.
Okay, 我要买这个房子。
He said, I've sold it.
多少钱？我卖掉了。
Sold it already.
你已经卖掉了。
I said, have they paid the money yet?
所以他们给钱了吗？
They said, no.
还没有啊。
Just the deposit.
那只是付了定金而已。
Because God tell me this is for us.
因为神告诉我这是我的。
So if it's for us, can't be for someone else.
如果是我的，那就不是其他人的。
I said, here's my card.
哎，这是我的卡。
When you can't sell the house,
如果你不能卖这个房子的话，
when the deal falls through,
如果这个买卖不成的话，
just give me a call,
你就打给我，
and we'll be ready.
我已经预备好了。
3 months later,
三个月后，
he rang me.
他打电话给我。
They can't get the money. They can't buy the house.
说那个
do you want to buy?
原本的买家没有办法交割，你要买吗？
And so we have a house.
所以我们就有一个现在的房子了。
We got lots of stories like that.
我们有许许多多这样类似这样的故事。
Story after story after story.
就是不断的有这样的故事。
Of being led by the Holy Spirit.
我就是被圣灵带领。
Now when you're led by the Holy Spirit,
当你被圣灵带领的时候，
you still have to be responsible for your decisions.
你还是要为你自己的决定负责任。
But you bring God into the process.
但是你把神带到那个做决定的这个当中。
He expects you to study.
他要你来去读他的话语，然后让你去认真的做决定，
to act wisely,
去研究来有智慧的决定。
But he wants to be engaged with you,
但是他想要参与其中，
and help you in the journey,
在这个旅程当中来去帮助你，
and guide you in what to do.
然后去引导你去做正确的事。
There are so many questions,
我们生命中有许多问题，
we need the Holy Spirit to guide us.
我们需要圣灵来引导我们。
When you practice daily surrendering to the Holy Spirit,
当你每天操练来去降服在圣灵的带领中
的时候， you lay your plans out,
你把你的计划打开，
and you invite him to guide you,
你就邀请他来去带领你，
and then you go about your business,
然后你就去做你该做的事，
trusting that through the day,
相信在这今天的当
中， he will guide you,
他就要去引领你。
How does he guide you?
他要怎么引领你呢？
There's a number of ways, but the most common way,
有许多方式，但其中一个
is a peace in your heart.
就是你心中有平安喜乐。
A peace in your heart.
你心中的平安。
If you're walking in the path he wants you,
如果你走在他所指引的道路
里， there's a peace in your heart.
心中必有平安。
If you're agitated,
如果你心中有点不舒服，
something is wrong.
也许就不太对了。
Wait, pray until God shows you what's wrong.
等待祷告，直到神告诉你什么不对。
It's not complex.
这不是很复杂的一件事情。
It's just knowing I'm loved.
但是只是知道我是被爱的。
Holy Spirit is here to help me.
圣灵在这边要帮助我。
I will involve him in my plans.
我要将他成为我做决定的一部分。
I'll talk to him about my marriage.
我每一天我要告诉他。
Talk to him about my problems.
我要跟谁结婚？我要跟我的问题。
Talk to him about my life.
跟他讲我生命中点滴。
Talk to him about people.
我要跟他讲我生命中遇见的人。
And ask him to lead me and guide me.
然后寻求他来帮助我，引导我。
I remember sitting down one day.
我记得有一天我坐在那里。
And I was feeling in my heart.
我在我的心中。
Disappointed.
有很多的。
And I wasn't sure why.
我也不知道为什么。
And so I sat down.
但是我就坐下。
And I thought I will write it out.
哦，我会把它写下来。
I will talk to the Holy Spirit.
我要跟圣灵讲。
So I began to write down.
我写下来。
All the things I'd felt disappointment over.
我许许多多我觉得很失望的事情。
And this was just about a year into COVID, so there were many things.
所以这是新冠发生一年后，所以有许许多多的事情。
And then I sat there.
然后我就坐在那里。
And I felt the Holy Spirit speak to me.
那我就觉得圣灵来告诉我。
And he said, I want to teach you about disappointment.
我要告诉你有关于失望失落的事。
And he showed me five powerful things about disappointment.
他就让我看见失望有带来五个很有能力的事。
And when I responded,
但是当我回应的时候
my joy was restored.
我的喜乐再次被恢复。
And the disappointment lifted off me.
那失望已经不在了。
The first thing he showed me,
第一件他所显示的是
disappointments accumulate.
这些失望是会不断的累积。
If you don't deal with them on a daily basis, they just grow and grow and grow.
你没有每天都在对付他，他就一断不再的累积。
Secondly,
第二件事情
，disappointments quench your love for him.
这个失落让你对神的爱被浇熄。
They cause your heart to grow cold.
让你的心变成冷淡。
Because you're disappointed.
因为你很失望。
And don't want to be hurt again.
你必须要，我不想要再被受
伤害了。So the Lord showed me some things about disappointment.
所以这个神教导我许多有关于失望的事情。
He wants to lead us.
他想要来带领我们。
Lead us in our decisions.
在我们每一个决定当中带领我们。
I found even when I make mistakes,
我发现也许我会做出错误的决定。
The Holy Spirit will turn them to good.
那圣灵也会常常改变成为好的。
I'll tell you one of the biggest mistakes, a big mistake I made.
我告诉你一个我曾经犯过一个最大的错。
Years ago, when I was a young minister,
在我很年轻的时候，作为一个年轻牧师的时候
，to speak in a church in North Auckland.
我在那个北 Auckland 那边讲道。
He was a good friend of mine.
那边是的牧师是我的好朋友。
We grew up in ministry together.
我们一起在服事的道路上一起成长。
And so I said, yes, I'd love to come.
我说好啊好啊，我一定要去。
So we planned the weekend.
所以我计划了那个周末要去。
Got in the car to go up there.
哎，我有开着车上去了。
It turns out I was a week early.
哦，结果我早了一周去了。
A week early.
哇，提早一周啊。
I have never done that before or since.
我从来没做过，之后也再也没做过这样的事情。
But we had prayed, we committed our way to the Lord.
然后呢，但是我就一直祷告来寻求神。
Get this, on the way up,
然后结果我上去
，we called into a hospital.
哎，结果我们去到一个医院。
Where I wanted to pray for a man I'd heard was very sick.
哦，因为我要去为一个我听到很生病、很病重的人祷告。
When I got there, he was unconscious.
他那时候已经昏迷了。
He was in a coma.
他已经是昏迷的状态。
He was in intensive care.
他是在重度医治，在 ICU。
I said, oh, what do I do?
啊，我要做什么
？I thought you were leading me.
我以为你要来带领我哎。
He's unconscious. I can't even speak to him.
他已经没有意识了，我根本没有办法对他说话。
The Lord just said.
那神对我说
，Talk to him like he's still listening.
你就对他说话，好像他听得到一样。
So I talked to him.
所以我就对他说话。
I shared the gospel.
我与他传福音。
I told him it's not sure whether he will survive.
我也不知道说我不知道你会不会继续活下去。
So he should pray the sinner's prayer.
所以你必须要现在跟我一起祷告。
And I will pray the prayer.
我现在祷告。
And he can just agree with it in his heart.
你只要在你心里认同就好了。
So I prayed the prayer.
所以我就为他祷告。
He didn't do a thing.
他当然什么都不知道，就让他躺在那
边。Masks and things on.
有很多的这个罩子啊。
And so I just wrote a little note to him.
所以我就写了一个小纸条。
And left him.
我就留给他了。
We went up to the meetings.
啊，我们就走了，我们就去继续去聚会了。
The very first meeting.
那第一个聚会。
One lady came up in the altar call.
所以有一个人来到前面，我当呼召的时候。
I made a decision.
我已经决定。
This was the last time I would come to church.
这是我最后一次要来到教会。
I'm planning to commit suicide.
因为我要自杀。
We prayed for her.
我为她祷告。
And she was set free.
然后她就得释放了。
If I'd come a week later,
如果我一个礼拜之后再来
，we would have missed it.
我们就没有办法遇见她。
When we came back,
当我回去的时候
，I checked in the hospital.
我们去到医院里面
，the man had died.
那个我祷告的人已经离开我们了。然后我就想
，and she said, "This is amazing."
她说这很奇妙。
Suddenly, he woke up.
他突然之间醒来一下。
And he asked for the man who'd come to visit him.
他就跟那个来去探望他的人说。
And he saw my letter.
他就看到我那封信。
And he told the nurse.
他跟护士说。
I received Jesus Christ.
我已经领受耶稣基督了。
See, even when things don't look like they could work good.
所以也许很多事情看起来好像不是很好。
God is able to work things out.
但是神会将它变成美好的事
情。So the Spirit of God comes within us.
所以当神的灵来到我们当中。
Transform us.
改变我们。
Grow us up.
使我们成长。
Establish us as children of God.
建立我们是神的儿女的身份。
And to lead us in our journey.
并且要带领我们在我们的旅途当中。
Help us with decisions.
来帮助我们做任何的决定。
Now the Holy Spirit also comes upon us.
那圣灵也临到我们当中。
Let's read in Acts 1 verse 8.
使徒行传一章八节。
Acts 1 verse 8.Jesus said this, you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you and be witnesses to me in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and all the ends of the earth.
但耶稣降临在你们身上，你就必得着能力，并要在耶路撒冷、犹太全地和撒玛利亚直到地极做我的见证。
So notice, Jesus has already breathed on his disciples.
所以耶稣已经将这样的事情告诉他的门徒了。
Receive the Spirit.So they're born again.
所以他们就重生了。
Now he says,
那现在他说,
you shall receive power.
你要领受能力。
And you'll be witnesses unto me.
你要为我来做见证。
He's promised to baptize them in the Holy Spirit.
他应许他们要使他们受圣灵的洗。
Water in, water out upon.
水到我们的身体里面，水淋到我们身上。
It's a different experience.
是完全不一样的领受。
A different experience.
是完全不一样的体验。
He said, "Don't go witnessing yet."
你说还不要去为我做见证。
You need the power of the Holy Spirit.
你需要圣灵的能力。
So that being baptized in the Spirit,
所以他们受圣灵的洗
is to encounter and experience the power of God.
就是要去领受经历圣灵的大能。
It is power for ministry.
是那有服事上的大能。
When we receive Jesus Christ,
当我们领受耶稣的时候
and the Spirit of God comes within us,
神的灵来到我们的里面
it is power to change.
是让我们改变。
It's power for me to change.
是使我来改变。
And for me to be led.
使我能够得到带领。
But the anointing of the Holy Spirit upon,
圣灵临到恩膏临到我们的时候
is power to minister to the needs of others.
是我们有能力来去服事来帮助其他的人。
He said, you shall receive power.
他说你要领受能力
and you shall be witnesses unto me.
是你要为我来做见证。
So the power of the Holy Spirit,
所以那圣灵的大能
is to make real that Jesus is alive.
是要使世人宣告耶稣是真实存在的。
It's to empower you to meet needs of people.
是要使你有能力来去帮助其他人所需。
To speak in a way that enters their heart.
是能够说那些能够真的深入扎入他们内心的话。
To pray for them and get them set free.
是使能够为他们的祷告使他们得释放。
To pray for them to be healed.
是使为他们祷告使他们能得医治。
Remember,
你要记得
if you're a son, a daughter of the living God,
如果你是属神的儿子或女儿的话
you are a builder of the Father's house.
你就是要去建造你父的家的人。
The Father is building people.
所以你的父是建造人的父。
So you're called to build people and minister to their needs.
所以你的呼召就是要去建立人们并且去帮助他们。
In 1 Corinthians 12:7,
在哥林多前书一章七节
It says, Now the manifestation of the Holy Spirit
那圣灵的彰显
is given to everyone
这是给所有人的
to build up others
是来去建造其他人的
God wants you to be a minister of the Spirit
是神要你能够成为那圣灵带着圣灵服事的人
He's not talking to pastors
他并不是只是跟牧师讲
He's talking to ordinary believers
他是对所有的信徒都在说这种话
He wants to flow through you
他要从你们流出
and minister to the needs of people,
并且去服侍那些有需要的人
to help people,
去帮助别人
to serve people,
去服侍别人
with the supernatural assistance of the Holy Spirit,
是带着那圣灵那超自然的帮助来去服侍其他人
you shall receive power,
你必定得着能力
so the power of the Holy Spirit,
所以那圣灵的能力
is to continue the works of Jesus,
是来去延续耶稣基督的事工
it's to continue his ministry,
是来去延续他的事工
God wants many sons and daughters
神要他众多的儿女
who are servants and ministers of God
就是来去成为服侍神服侍人的人
so the promise of the Holy Spirit was fulfilled
所以那圣灵的应许已经得着了
in Acts chapter 2
已经应验了在
in the first four verses
在使徒行传二章
they were gathered together
前面世界他说他们聚集在一起
and they were hungry
然后他们就很饥渴
they were seeking God
他们就饥渴想要寻求神
for the promise of power No idea what would happen. This had never happened before. And as they were crying out to God,
所以当他们呼求的时候,
the Holy Spirit fell on them.
就圣灵就临到他们的身上。
And they were filled with the Spirit.
他们就被圣灵充满了。
They were filled up to overflowing.
他们就充满了并且满意。
And they began to speak in tongues.
我看开始说方言。
A new language.
一个新的语言。
Worshiping God.
来去敬拜神。
Praising God.
来去赞美神。
As the Spirit gave them the language.
因为圣灵就赐给他们这样新的一个语言。
Not a language they learned.
并不是他们所学过的语言。
A supernatural empowerment.
是一个超自然的这样子的一个领受。
The gift of God.
是那从神来的礼物
manifesting in a language
是要在是话语当中来彰显出来。
When Peter stood up to explain this,
当彼得站起来要解释的时候
he said in Acts 2:39,
他在使徒行传后面说
this promise
这个应许
is for you
是给你们
for your children
你们的儿女
and for all who are afar off
并一切在远方的人
and many were saved that day
许许多人就被
the promise of the Spirit
那圣灵的应许
to be transformed from within,
从内在的更新
to be anointed from above,
再从上面来的恩膏
so you can serve the Lord,
所以你就可以服侍神
is Father's plan for his church,
并且去成就神为他教会所命定的事情
this promise of the Holy Spirit,
这个应也带来圣灵的应许
is for every person,
是给每一个人的
It's not to do with age.
并不在乎你多大。
Even young children can be filled with the Spirit.
这么小的孩子也可以被圣灵充满。
Speak in tongues.
说方言。
Have visions and dreams.
看异象做异梦。
Start to operate prophetically.
能够来去做先知性的预言。
Be used by God to pray for people.
能够被神来使用来去为别人来祷告。
It's only religion stops people doing this.
而是只是那些宗教的仪式来去阻拦了我们。
It's wrong doctrine and concepts.
是那不对的错误的教义和教导。
We think we have to be perfect.
让我们认为我们要成为
mature,
完全或者是成熟
But God wants a willing heart,
但是神要的只是一个饥渴慕义愿意的心啊主啊我渴慕你
Put fire upon me,
你就自立火来到生命吗
spirit,
让我来圣灵来充满我吧使用我来去服侍别人
Amen,
Amen
What can we say?
我们能够说什么呢
When, after I got filled with the Holy Spirit,
当我被圣灵充满的时候
we went to a small town.
我们去到一个小镇
Very small town in New Zealand.
但是在纽西兰里面都算很小的小镇。
6,000 people.
六千个人。
And I was teaching in high school.
我在一个高中里面教书。
And there were other Christians on staff.
那里面有许许多基督徒。
But none of them were filled with the Holy Spirit.
但是那些人都没有受圣灵的洗。
And none of them doing anything to help these young people.
所以他们就没有办法做任何事情来帮助这些年轻人。
And the Lord put on my heart a burden.
神就给我一个极大的负担。
To pray for them.
来去为他们祷告。
And he showed me how to pray.
神就教导我怎么祷告。
So we began to pray.
我就开始祷告。
And every day I would pray in my classroom.
所以每一天我就在我的教室里面祷告。
It's a very old room.
非常老的一个
And the Lord taught me take authority over demons.
他说我们要有权柄来对付这些邪灵
Because they torment the children.
因为他们来去搅扰我的孩子
And stop them learning.
让他们没有办法好好学习
So I would go into my room.
所以我去到我的那个教室里面
And I would walk around the room.
我这样走啊走
And I'd lay hands on the seats.
我就按手在那个椅子上
And I would begin to pray.
然后就开始祷告
I take authority in Jesus' name.
我奉耶稣的基督名我权柄
I forbid any demon to operate.
我要限制任何的邪灵
On the person that sits in that chair.
来限制他来去搅扰坐在这里的人
into the atmosphere,
我要释放你
the presence of God,
那在这里要充满神的同在
I declare in this place,
我们要宣告
learning,
这里要学习
peace,
要有平安
So that's what I did
这就是我所做的
He said, How did you, why did you do that?
他说你们为什么要做这种事情
I'm being led by the Holy Spirit
因为我是圣灵来带领我做的事情
My head was saying, having an argument
我脑袋里面其实不是这样
Very big argument
其实不太一样的交战啊
You're a physics teacher.
你是一个物理老师。
Why are you doing these things?
你在做什么啊？
You're going just too far.
你这样太过分了。
If someone sees,
如果有人看到
this is a problem.
这是一个很大的问题哎。
But my spirit is saying,
但我的灵说
do what God says.
神教你怎么做，你就怎么做。
So I began to pray every day.
所以我每天就这样祷告。
Before school start,
在学校开始之前
pray,
祷告
pray,
祷告
release peace.
我们来释放
bind the demons.
我来捆绑邪灵
release learning.
我们能够使他们能够学习
This is what happened.
这就是然后发生了什么事情
Without me knowing it,
我不知道，虽然我不知道
the atmosphere began to fill with the presence of God.
这个属灵的空气完全改变了
I didn't even know it.
我根本不知道哎。
I'm just happy teaching.
我只是很开心地教我的书。
And everyone's very quiet and they're learning.
每个人就很安静地在那边学习。
And one of the other teachers came to me.
结果有另外一个老师来到我面前说。
And she said,
他说
What's up with your room?
你的教室怎么了？
I said, What do you mean?
你什么意思啊？
And she said, It's different to every other room in the building.
其他的教室都不一样哎。
I said, why is it different?
他说有什么不一样？
She said, well, I do study classes around the school.
因为我去每个不同的教室教书。
And it's always difficult.
每一个教室它都很难。
But this room,
这个教室。
Everyone's peaceful and quiet.
每个人都很平安
的，很安静的。We all get our work done.
我就把我该教的做完了。
It's a very good room.
是一个很好的一个教室。
I said, I don't think you want to know why.
我想说，我说你可能不想知道为什么。
Please tell me.
他说，拜托你一定要告诉我。
No, I'm sure you don't know what to why.
我很确定你一定不想知道。
She said, tell me.
他说啊，拜托拜托拜托。
I said, okay.
我说好好好。
So you're telling me it's peaceful?
你告诉我这是很有平安吗
？Most peaceful room in the school.
在这个学校里面最有平安的。
Everyone here studies.
大家都在里面好好学习。
This is why.
这是为什么？
I pray.
因为我祷告。
And this is what I pray.
这是我怎么祷告的
？And she looked at me.
她看到我呀。
I said, I told you you wouldn't like my answer.
我说了你一定不会喜欢我的答案的嘛。
Another day.
结果有另外一天呢。
I'm just standing at my desk.
我就在我的讲台上。
And two girls come the door.
两个人小女孩来了。
I say, hey, teacher.
说老师啊，老师。
What's up with your room?
你就是发生什么事情了
？I said, what do you mean?
我说你什么意思啊
？They said it's the strangest room in the school.
这是这个学校里面最奇怪的一个房间呐。
Strange room. Why is it strange?
为什么这个教室很奇怪
said, Because when we go by your room,
因为我从我经过你教室的时候
we begin to shake.
我就好像在那边发抖一样
See, we're shaking now.
我现在就在发抖耶
I said, Oh, I've never seen shaking before.
我从来没有看到这样的事情啊
They're shaking.
然后他们就发抖
I said, Please come in.
进来吧
Come in.
进来吧
And because I'm a science teacher, I want to see. Come in.
我是物理老师，我想看到
So now they've come into where the fire is.
他就看进到了
Now they're really shaking.
他们就要发抖了
And I suddenly realized.
我就突然就知道了。
These girls have been involved with witchcraft.
原来他们去有经历一些邪术的事情。
They've been involved in spiritism.
就是有些属灵邪术的事情。
They've got demons. And every time they go by the room,
他每次经过那个教室的
时候 the demons get agitated by my room.
那里面的邪灵就很害怕了。
I said, "Whoa, this is exciting."
哇，这个好刺激啊
I got very bold.
我很放胆，有胆量哎。
I said to them,
我对他们说
"The presence of God is in this room."
神的灵充满这地。
And there's Inside you are spirits that are reacting.
在你里面，里面有邪灵，他们很害怕。
I could have stopped there.
我可以在这里就
停了。But I was very excited by now.
但是我其实非常兴奋。
And I said, and I can stop that shaking.
我可以停止这样子的这个震动。
And immediately I thought.
马上我就想。
You've never seen shaking. How do you know you can stop it?
你从来没有看过人这样震抖，你怎么可能停止它呢
？They said, okay, do it.
他说。好吧，做吧。
And so I prayed.
所以我就祷告了。
I prayed two prayers.
我做了两个祷告。
One they heard.
一个是可以听到的。
You know what that one was?
是什么呢
？Help!
Help! 救命啊
！Don't know what to do.
我不知道该做什么。
I've never done this before.
我从来没做过哎。
I don't know what to do.
我不知道该做什么。
Help!
帮助。
Remember the Holy Spirit is our helper.
记得那圣灵就是帮助我们的。
He said, "Do this."
他说做这个。
I prayed.
我祷告。
Immediately the shaking stopped.
马上那个颤抖就停止。
We led the girls to the Lord.
我们带领这些孩子们信主。
We started to have a move of God in our church.
我们就看见
in the school.
在学校里面就有神的运动。
Come on, give Jesus a clap.
我应该要向荣耀归给我的神吧。
Come on, we need more people that will pray.
我们也需要更多人能够做这样子的祷告。
That's what the power of the Spirit is for.
这就是圣灵的大能所最大的用处啊
！I got lots of stories like that.
我有许许多多这样子的故事。
Oh, praying in the workplace.
在你的工作职场上祷告。
Productivity went up.
使你的那个绩效变好。
And things went better.
这样子你所做的事情都是好的。
Over the course of 3 years.
在三年之中。
My class grades all went up like that.
我学校我学生的成绩一路的往上走。
And within 3 years,
在三年里面
，from only having a few students,
原本只有几个学生。
People not so fussed about physics.
因为大家不是很喜欢物理啊。
Now I get the whole class filled.
我教室都
充
都是人了。
Three classes,
哇，三个教室。
Four classes,
四个教室。
Soon I have all the upper school.
哇，原来结果我整个学校上层都是我的了。
The power of God,
神的大能。
Causing results in the marketplace,
能够使在这世上这有极大的一个成就
You shall receive power.
你要领受能力
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. What we want, I need to finish this now.
我现在要来做一个总结
There's a number of scriptures.
但是圣经里面有许多的经文
that tell us when the Holy Spirit came upon people.
告诉我们当圣灵临到人的时候
they were filled.
他们就被充满
Now, if you're filled.
如果你说被充满
then something should overflow.
那有一些东西应该满出来啊。
There should be an overflow.
应该要满溢出来才
对啊。Overflow of joy.
是喜乐要满溢出
来。Overflow of life.
是的生命要满溢出来。
Some of you need an overflow.
你们的有些人的生命需要被什么满溢出来？
God
需要神的灵
to fill you up.
来去充满你。
In Acts chapter 10,
在使徒行传十章
when the Holy Spirit fell on them,
当那圣灵临到他们的时候
they spoke in tongues and worshiped God.
他们就用方言来祷告和敬拜。
Acts 19, when the Holy Spirit came on them.
当圣灵临到他们的时候
They spoke in tongues and prophesied.
他们就说方言说预言
So what is this speaking in tongues?
所以这个说方言是什么
It is a gift that God gives
是一个属神来的礼物
To help you grow in your spirit
是帮助你来内在你的灵里成长
it's a gift God gives
是神来的礼物
To help you become powerful in prayer
在使你的祷告充满大能。
Don't neglect the gift of God.
你不要去小看这神的礼物啊。
There's a number of purposes for praying in tongues.
这个祷告用方言祷告有几个一个重要的。
You can read it in 1 Corinthians 14.
这经文都会打出来。
In verse 14,
第十四节
it tells us when you pray in the Spirit.
当你在用圣灵方言祷告的时候
pray in tongues,
当你用方言祷告的时候
your spirit is praying.
你的灵也在祷告。
So you can pray with your head.
你可以用你的头脑祷告
pray from your spirit.
或者是从你的灵里祷告
So when you're praying in tongues,
当你用方言祷告的时候
Number one,
第一件事情
Your spirit becomes activated
你的灵就被启发
了 Your spirit starts to work
你的灵里面就开始运动了
Your spirit starts to exercise
你的灵好像开始运动了
So when you pray in tongues
所以当你用方言祷告的时候
Your spirit is operating within you
你的灵就被充就激发了
Secondly,
第二件事情
When you pray in the spirit
当你用灵来祷告的时候
You are praying a language the Holy Spirit is giving you
你是用那圣灵所赐给你的话语来祷告。
The anointing of the Spirit of God flows through you.
那圣灵的恩膏从你里面流露出来。
You are opening a way and a flow of the Holy Spirit.
你是打开了一个出口，使圣灵的恩膏能够敞开出去。
Thirdly,
第三件事情。
When you pray in the Spirit,
当你用圣灵来祷告的时候。
When you start to heal to the Holy Spirit,
当你在被圣灵的医治的时候。
The Bible tells us you build up your spirit.
就说你的灵被更新和更正和坚固。
In 1 Corinthians 14:4.
跟你们说
When you pray in tongues,
当你用灵长
通方言的 You are building your spirit man.
是造就自己，造就你的灵人。
No one can do this for you.
没有任何人能够为你做。
You can pray in tongues.
你可以在灵里用方言祷告。
Build your spirit man.
来去建造你内在的灵人。
So you become powerful on the inside.
所以你的内在有强大的力量。
Or you can be weak on the inside.
或者你内在可以是很虚弱。
If you do nothing, you'll be weak.
如果你什么都不做，你就是虚弱软弱的人。
Strong in spirit,
神要你内在的灵人能够成长健壮。
With supernatural power in your spirit,
是在内在有超自然的你去坚固它的。
The gift of tongues helps with that.
所以他说方言是可以帮助这件事情。
When you pray in the spirit,
当你用灵里祷告的时
候 you alter the spiritual atmosphere around you.
就改变的在身你附近的属灵气味。
You become aware, more sensitive of the Holy Spirit.
你就能够更灵敏的知道圣灵所要动的工事。
Your mind becomes clear.
你的脑子更清楚。
And you begin to get.Revelation from the Holy Spirit.
你就是从圣灵那边领到启示。
It is such a powerful gift.
是一个极为力量有力量的一个礼物。
We have at the end of our street.
在我们家的后面。
At the end of our street, we have a long track, cycling track.
是有一个很长的可以骑脚踏车的一个。
So you can walk down there and pray, and no one knows you there.
所以你也可以走路在那边，然后边走边祷告，没人知道在那
边。So I go down there.
所以我每天在那边走。
And I pray in the Spirit.
我就用灵祷告。
So when I do that,
so 我这样做的时候
I can just walk in a straight line,
我这样走,
praying in the Spirit. Now, I was doing this one day,
我一天我这样做
just praying in the Spirit,
我在灵里用方言祷告
and there was a lady come towards me.
结果有一个老太太从我
走过来 and she's out for a walk.
她这样走走走走走
you know? And she's a Christian lady.
其实她是一个基督徒。
And as she came near me,
她来我
about there,
这个这么前的时候
and I'm praying in the spirit.
Oh, shut up!
She just fell over on the ground.
砰，她就倒的。
Just like that.
哎呀
，and I was quite surprised.
我说哎
，and I suddenly realized.
我说哎
，she's a Christian.
哦，她是个基督徒。
And she's experienced the power of God touching her.
哦，她就领受到从神来的这个
力。So even though I wasn't aware of it,
也许虽然我不知道
，I guess I've kind of got used to it.
也许因为我就常常是因为我常常做。
The presence of God was there.
但是神的同在就在那里。
And she's very sensitive, and it touched her very powerfully.
她很敏感，所以就是很大能的来去触摸她的。
Lots of things like that.
我会发现很多这样的。
When I go walking and praying,
当我在走路祷告的时候
I keep my phone with me.
我的手机有。
Because I never know when God will give ideas.
因为我不知道，永远不知道神什么时候给我一些意象，
messages,
哦，或者是一些话语
，ideas for ministry，
啊，是给我事工里面的一些
ideas for my family，
想法对我家庭的一些想法。
I have a special part,、啊、Holy Spirit inspired ideas。
啊，我有一个部分是写说圣灵所启示我的。
I get them during worship。
哎，我在圣讲到的时候。
I get them while I'm praying。
啊，我在祷告的时候。
When you pray in the Spirit，
当你用方言祷告的时候
，you build your inner life，
你就建立你的内在的生命，就成为坚固的。
Now, no one can make you do it，
没有人能够强迫你去做。
So you have to develop a prayer life，
所以你必须要去建造、建立一个
prayer life，
很强力、强壮的一个祷告的生活。这是你的责任。
The Holy Spirit won't make you pray，
圣灵并不会让你要祷告。
You choose to get up and pray，
是你自己愿意起床祷告。
So when you pray in the Spirit，
所以当你用灵力祷告的时候
，practice praying strongly，
你要去练习操练，你要很强大的祷告。
Let your voice come out，
让你的话语说出来。
Don't mumble，
不要只是这样子，不。
Don't mumble.
你不要只是这样喃喃自语，要很坚强的
voice to your spirit，
坚定的来说话。
As you're praying in the spirit，
当你用灵来祷告的时候
，the Holy Spirit helps you pray for people。
圣灵就来带领你，帮助你为其他人祷告。
We don't know what to pray，
我们不知道祷告什么。
But the Holy Spirit helps us。
但是那圣灵是帮助我们的。
So we need to be activated。
所以我们需要被启动、启发。
Now the Bible tells us。
所以这圣经告诉我们。
How we can receive。
我要怎么领受
？If you haven't already received。
如果你还没有领受过的话。
Let me give you four simple keys。
让我给你四个方向。
And then we'll just have a time of prayer。
然后我们就来开始祷告。
For people to be activated。
然后就让我们有看到神
被启发、启动。In Mark chapter 11:24。
在今天里面
，Jesus said this。
耶稣这样说。
Now listen for the keys.
注意听那些
关键字。Whatever things you desire,
那你所渴望的
desire,
你渴望的
you must want to be filled with the Spirit.
你必须要渴望想要被圣灵充满。
You must want the Holy Spirit.
你必须想要得到
you must want the power of the Spirit.
你必须饥渴的想要。
You can't sort of come to God and say,、oh, I don't know, maybe.
啊，你不能这样来到神说，哦，我也不知道。
Maybe if you want me to have it.
可能吧，如果你真的一定要给我的话，好吧。
It doesn't work anywhere.
并不是这样子的。
You go imagine going to McDonald's.
如果你想象到麦当劳。
And I finally get to the front of the queue.
啊，你走到那个前面。
And the lady there say, "Hey, what you want?"
她说，哎，你要点什么？
Oh, I don't know.
哎呀，我不知道哎。
Whatever you feel.
你觉得什么好吃，你就给我吧。
It's not going to work.
这样子是没有办法成就事情的。
She said, "Go home, clear your head, come back when you know what you want."
他就说你回家吧，你想清楚明白了再来。
So desire is important.
所以渴望、渴慕是很重要的。
Desire the Holy Spirit.
你要去渴慕圣灵啊。
Whatever things you desire, when you pray.
所以当你祷告，你到底渴慕什么
？You need to ask specifically.
你要非常的清楚的来去寻求。
Holy Spirit, come and fill me.
你说圣灵。来充满我
Lord, I want to be baptized in the Spirit.
说圣灵啊，我要被受圣灵的洗。
I want to speak in a new language.
我要说那新的语言。
Don't be confident.
你要有自信。
Be bold.
你要有壮胆。
Whatever things you desire,
你所渴慕的。
When you pray,
当你祷告。
Must believe.
你要相信。
Believe what?
你要相信什么呢
？Believe God will give the gift to me.
相信神要把这样子的礼物赐给我。
This promise is for you, your children, all who far off. That's me.
你的应许是要给所有人，是要给你的孩子，也就是我。
We're about as far off down here in New Zealand as you can get from Israel.
虽然我们从以色列算起来，我们处在地极的这边，但是这也是要给我们的。
So whatever things you desire,
你所说渴慕的
，when you pray, ask,
你祷告
，believe,
你要相信
，and receive,
那就领受了。
Me.
我领受了
I receive it now.
我现在就领受了
So since all of you are involved in ministry in some level
也许我们在这里大家都参与在服事当中
When I'm leading people to experience the Holy Spirit
当我来去带领大家来去受圣灵的洗的时候
I follow just some simple steps
有一些基本的一些步骤
I'll give them to you
我现在跟你们分享
The first thing
第一件事情
And I've already done it
我已经告诉你们了
You share testimony about the Holy Spirit
你就是要跟人分享有关圣灵的见证所以人家知道哦
Who I want
哎我也要哎
I want what you've got
哎那个我也想要
Testimony
见证
Secondly you share some scriptures
第二个你要分享经节
Jesus promise
耶稣的应许
You shall receive power
你要领受能力
Study the scriptures, get them in your Bible so you know what they are.
你要好好读圣经，放在你的这个写下来。
And then explain.
你要去告诉他们，然后继续解释。
This is what God will do.
这就是神会做什么。
He will fill you with the Spirit.
他会充满圣灵，充满你。这是我要做什么。
I will lead you in a prayer.
我会带你来祷告。
This is what you will do.
啊，这是你要做什么呢？
You will follow in the prayer.
你要跟着我祷告。
And at the end of the prayer,
如果在这个祷告之后
do two things.
做两件事情。
One,
一
take a deep breath in like you're receiving something from God.
这样大大深呼吸，就好像你领受了。
And then secondly, speak in tongues.
然后就开始说方言吧。
Speak from within your spirit.
从你内在的里面说出来。
And we will all join in with you.
然后我们就在里面，我们就一起来跟你一起来用方言。
I have prayed for hundreds and thousands of people.
我为数以千万计的人祷告。
It's just in the preparation.
就是我们知道这个预备动作很重要。
Otherwise, you pray and you don't understand why nothing happens.
啊，不然你就祷告说为什么什么事情也没有成就。
You must prepare people.
你必须要预备他们来去领受。
Prepare them to receive.
预备来领受。
Testify about the Holy Spirit.
来去见证圣灵。
Create hunger.
来去使他们的饥渴慕义。
Share the word of God.
来跟他们分享神的话。
Create faith.
是让他们有信心。
Then explain how to receive.
要去解释怎么得着。
This is what God will do.
这是神怎么做。
Because He wants to do this.
是因为他愿意这样做。
He wants to fill you.
因为是因为他愿意来去充满你。
This is what I will do.
这是我要怎么做。
I will lead you in prayer.
我会带领你来祷告。
Then lay hands on you.
然后就按手在你
身上。This is what you will do.
这是你又要做什么。
You will follow the prayer.
你会跟着我祷告。
Desire.
你要渴慕。
Ask.
祷告
believe
相信
receive
领受
and take a deep breath
深呼吸
and begin to pray
然后就开始就用
敲啪啪啪敲啪啪啪 it is quite simple
很简单对不对
Amen well we've prayed we've done this for long enough now
我们这样做过很多
次 so why don't we all stand on our feet
我们一起来起立吧
just stand on your feet wherever you are
不管你坐在哪里
come on let's begin to stand on our feet
我们一起起立吧
and we want people to experience the Holy Spirit
我要人们来去领受圣灵
tonight I'll pray for lots of people
今天我会为很多人今天晚上为很多人祷告
we'll have an altar call
我们会有呼召
for ministry to set people free
是让使人释放的事
but this time I want you to receive the power of the Holy Spirit
但是现在我就是要来领受圣灵的能力
how many people here
这里里面
not yet filled with the Spirit
你还没有受过圣灵的心 and not yet speaking in tongues 还没有说方言
you just raise your hand right now
你把手举起来
there's a number of people around
有许多人
oh,
还有蛮多人
look at that wonderful
这是多好的
Now God wants you to receive.
因为神要你来领受。
So this is what we'll do.
这是我要做的事情。
Why don't you all come right up to the front right now?
你愿意的人来到前面来。
Just make your way up to the front right now.
让那些还没有领受的人先来到前面来。
That's
快快快快快。
That's right. Run. That's the way.
快要跑啊，要渴慕啊，要跑啊。
Down on the carpet.
在下面，在这个地毯上面。
Otherwise, it's too far to fall. Okay, make a row.Make a row.
前面可不可以留一条通道？
In the second row.
然后每一个人之间可不可以留一些通道，好吗？
That's great, that's great. Okay, we've got someone behind you. All right.
Okay, 每个人后面都有人接着你啊。
Okay. Right, close your eyes for just a moment.
现在闭上你的眼睛。
Close your eyes now.
眼睛。
Sometimes people struggle.
有些时候人们开始有一些困
扰。For these reasons.
有几个原因啊。
So just listen carefully.
你好好仔细的听。
If anyone has taught you against the Holy Spirit.
所以有些人教导你就是。
Taught against the gift of tongues.
就是。不是对于让你不要领受圣灵
quietly in your heart
在你的心中里面
just renounce that teaching
你就去来去否定否决
and forgive the person
不要再这样子去接受这样的教导并且原谅那些教给你这样教导的人
secondly
第二件事情
if you've been deeply hurt by someone
如果你曾经被人什么人深深的伤害过
and you don't feel you very much value
你并不觉得说你是有价值的
you struggle to receive a gift
你好觉得说我不配得得到一个礼物
Forgive that person.
你也请你原谅他，现在就原谅他。
The third reason sometimes
第三个可能的原因
is that people are afraid just to let go control.
因为有些人他可能觉得我不想要将我的主权交出。
They're afraid of what people will think of them.
我不知道别人会怎么看待我。
So just to help with that,
所以我们怎么来去解决呢？
This is what we will do.
这是我要做的。
I will lead you in a prayer.
我会带你们做一个祷告。
And you will follow.
然后你就跟着我祷告。
At the end of the prayer,
就在祷告最后。
I want you to do two things.
我要你做两件事情。
Take in a deep breath. To receive the gift of God.
来去领受神的祝福。
Because the word spirit means breath.
因为圣灵这个词就是。
And then secondly, begin to speak in the new language.
然后就用那新的语言。
We'll come and lay hands on you.
我会按手在你身
上。And I want everyone praying out loud and strong.
我要让所有人都大声的来去坚强的、坚定的祷告，让这地充满的祷告。
Are you ready?
你们预备好了吗？
I lead you in the prayer.
我来带你们祷告。
You follow in the prayer.
你跟着我祷告。
Deep breath.
深呼吸
Receive the baptism of the Spirit
领受圣灵的心
And pray in tongues
然后就开始用方言祷告吧
Everyone will pray
每一个人都要祷告
Musicians will praise the Lord
让我们一起来赞美我们的神
Then we'll come and lay hands on you
然后我们就按手在你身上
Now no one's going to make your mouth work You have to speak
没有人能够使你张开口只有你自己可以
Okay, are we ready then?
你们预备好了吗
So lift your hands to the Lord
让你的手举起来向神举手
Now, just so we don't end up messy I'd like you to follow Jeff.
所以请你们跟中文的祷告。
I will speak in English.
所以牧师用英文来说。
He'll speak in Mandarin.
我会用中文翻译。
You follow him.
你们跟着我用中文祷告。预备好了吗？
Okay, Father, I come to you in Jesus' name.
父神，我来到你的面前。
父神，我来到你的面前。
I want to be baptized in the Spirit.
我要受圣灵的洗。
我要受圣灵的洗。
I want to receive the power of God.
我要去领受神的大能。
我要去领受神的大能。
I want to receive the gift of tongues.
我要去领受方言的礼物。
我要去领受方言的礼物。
So I can become powerful in prayer.
所以我能够在我的祷告里带有能力。
所以我能够在我的祷告里带有能力。
Lord, I need your Spirit.
主啊，我需要你。
主，我需要你。
So by faith now，
所以我带着信心。
所以我带着信心。
I receive the Holy Ghost，
我就领受。
我就领受。
I receive the gift of tongues，
领受方言的恩赐。
领受方言的恩赐。
And I thank you, Lord，
我谢谢你。
谢谢你。
In my new language，
让我用我新的语言。
让我用我新的语言。
Okay, on the count of three, receive。
我数到三，我就领受。
One, 1 2 3 Receive! In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I release the power of God. I release the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Holy Ghost, touch right now. Holy Ghost, touch right now. Holy Ghost, come upon her right now. Feel right now. Thank you, Lord. Feel right now. Feel. Pass away. Feel, Holy Ghost. Feel her right now.That's right. Speak in your new language. Speak in your new language. Speak strongly. Okay, just stop for a moment.
你们先听一下。
Let's give Jesus a big clap.
我要给耶稣一个极大的掌声。
So many people praying in the Spirit.
有许许多多人来用圣灵来祷告。
Jesus, we honor you.
耶稣，我来尊荣你。
Now we can pray whenever we wish.
我也许什么时候都可以祷告。
All you have to do is decide. I want to pray.
我要祷告。
Perhaps pray in Mandarin.
用中文祷告。
And break into tongues.
我来去用我的方言来祷告。
So on the count of three,
所以我数到三。
We will all pray in tongues.
我要一起用方言祷告。
Strongly.
那非常坚定坚强祷告。预备好了吗？
一、二、三。Holy Spirit, fill this place.
圣灵来充满这地，就用着你充满这地，充满着能力啊！
Thank you, Lord.
谢谢主。
Thank you, Lord. We honor you, Lord. Why just stop right now? Stop for a moment. Now just listen now. This time as you pray, move your body as well. Like you're shaking your body to wake up. And as you do, pray strongly from within your spirit. You will notice you come alive and awake on the inside.
Just
move your body. Because you break the apathy of your body.
突破你身体的束缚。
Your body doesn't want to pray.
你的身体不想要来去祷告，但是你的灵想要祷告。
So just move your body like this.
所以你要去惊动你的身体。
And let's pray strongly in tongues.
你要是非常强力的来祷告。
30 seconds.
来三十秒，很激动的来祷告。
一、二、三。沙巴巴巴巴巴西卡巴巴巴巴巴西卡巴里亚纳。沙巴巴巴巴巴巴巴西卡巴里亚纳。沙巴巴巴巴巴巴巴西卡巴里亚纳。沙巴巴巴巴巴巴西卡巴里亚纳。Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
We thank you, Lord. We thank you for the gift of God. Thank you for the gift of tongues. Thank you, Lord. 谢谢主。